Good morning, everybody. For those of you that missed the major announcement, from now until the end of December, every single quest pack in Dungeons & Dragons Online is free. But not just free to play, free to own. That's right, all you have to do is enter in the code you're about to see on screen, DDOQuests2021, and it gives you access to every single quest pack. Now, while this doesn't include expansions, it's 90% of all of the content in the game, and that's pretty good. However, it doesn't just stop there. Not only do you get 90% of the content, three of the expansions, The Menace of the Underdark, The Shadowfell Conspiracy, and The Mists of Ravenloft, are all available for only 99 DDO points each. Which means for just 300 points, you're able to get yourself about 95% of the content, with the last little bit being Sharn, Feywild, and the Secrets of the Saltmarsh just being left out. Now, this amount of content is so great and so massive and so easy to come by, there is no reason to not get it. Just get it. If you don't have DDO installed, go install it right now, download the client through Steam or the standalone client, get your account and just put it in. You don't know when you're going to be playing DDO. Maybe you're somebody who's just thought about it and you're unsure. Just do it right now. Don't think about it. Put in the code. You'll be happy with yourself. Not only can you use this as an opportunity to get all the quest packs for yourself, but if you've been trying to find a reason to get a friend to come and play and you're like, hey, this cool game, it's Dungeons & Dragons Online, you should really play it with me, and they've been hemming and hawing, this is the perfect opportunity to introduce any friends that you might have to get to play with you. Because this game is honestly a lot more fun when you can play it with friends and to explore it with a new party, so this would be a great opportunity. Additionally, if you are an existing player, this is great as well, because like myself, it's nice to have an alternate account open and available for holding different types of quest locks, the best example of which is Shadow Crypt. If you happen to make an account, a secondary account, you can have access to all the quests right now, get that character flagged for Shadow Crypt, and now every time you run a past life, log in that alt account, bring him in, open the dungeon, and never worry about having to flag for Shadow Crypt ever again, among other things. Want a secondary loot puller? No problem, just log in that alt account. Now, as I said, getting the other three expansions is only 300 DDO points. However, that's not a big expense. It's like $5 or something. Spend some points in the store. You could probably buy a couple other things if you want to and get yourself access to all of those expansions permanently unlocked on your account. However, you may not currently have that $5 to be able to get on these expansions. So that's why I have for you the actual information on what exactly you need to do to earn the DDO points fast. If you're not familiar with Dungeons & Dragons Online, just by playing the game and doing the quests, you actually unlock the points in the store, meaning you can play this game fully free to play. And it's definitely going to be a lot easier when you have all the quest packs available right now and the expansions. So here is a little bit of a guide on how to get yourself every single quest pack and all the expansions that are available here for 99 points unlocked in just a few hours. The first thing you're going to do is create a human barbarian on a server that you have never played before. The reason is that when you earn favor doing quests, there is actually a first-time bonus on any servers that you haven't gotten it already. The benefit of this is that for the first 50 points of favor on a server that you've unlocked, you actually get 100 DDO points. This means that instead of having to earn 400 favor per expansion pack, which is what the normal conversion rate as it's 25 points of DDO for every 100 points of favor, instead, you only have to get 50 on three different servers you've never played on, and that gives you enough points. So you make a human barbarian, and this human barbarian, you're going to be putting all of your points into strength, constitution, and then whatever remaining points you have into dex. Just max out the strength, max out the constitution, and whatever you have left in dexterity. When it comes to your skills, you're going to want to take jump and swim. The rest of the skills don't matter. Put them into whatever you like. You do not need any other skills. As for the feats, at here you're going to take two-handed fighting. Generally you'd want to take something for area of effect, and this does a very good job. And then after that, you're going to take the least dragon mark of passage. This dragon mark allows you to cast Expeditious Retreat, and since you are in fact a human, that allows you to run at 35% additional movement speed, 10% for being a barbarian, and thanks to the human dragon mark, 25% from Expeditious Retreat at level 1 with no ship buffs, no assistance from any other players, just fast movement. Once you get yourself into the game, your job will be to quickly head off the beach and clear through the entrance of the Grotto quest, and complete it to get yourself onto Korthos Island. Once you're on Korthos, you're going to be doing a series of quests in order that I'll detail for you right now to get your 50 favor. First, you'll do the Storehouse Secret on Normal, Hard, and Elite, and then you will do Hayton's Rest on Normal. After that, you will run the Caneth Crystal on Normal, and then you will run the Collaborator on Normal, Hard, and Elite. This will bring you to a total of 22 favor, meaning you only need to earn an extra 28 to get that last 50. The reason for this quest order is that the Storehouse Secret is very quick and can get you a little bit of gold so you can buy a hireling, and I highly recommend that you immediately, as soon as you have any amount of gold, go purchase the Cleric Hireling on Korthos Island and then just use her to help keep you safe as you're running through content and you're smashing through monsters. As you earn experience points, make sure you're putting your points into the Frenzied Berserker tree and start with Cracking Attack. Cracking Attack is a very powerful attack, it just does a bunch of damage, so you want to make sure you're using that as often as possible to cleave through monsters as you're running. Then once you have Cracking Attack maxed out, the next thing you want to get is the Sprint Boost, Action Boost. The Sprint Boost will allow you to move extremely fast. You can use it in town, you can use it through dungeons. If you're just mashing Sprint Boost constantly, you're going to be going quite fast. And of course, every single time you get the opportunity, take your level up. Now most of the gear here doesn't matter. Every quest is going to be normal, hard, or elite, and most of the quests are actually going to be normal and hard, so your equipment is kind of irrelevant. The only thing that you want to try to get is if you see a two-handed weapon, pretty much any two-handed weapon with melee stats, like a shocking or a holy weapon, those are the ones you want to go for. Make sure you have a two-handed weapon. You get an Ember Great Axe for free, but I found a plus one Holy Great Axe while I was practicing, falchions, that sort of thing. Anything that's a two-handed weapon, big sword or axe, and go from there. Now, once you have completed the Collaborator on Normal, Hard, and Elite, this is where you want to go to the harbor. Once you're inside the harbor, you're going to want to be walking up some of the ramps and heading to Bringing the Light, and this quest you're going to do on Normal and Hard. It's fairly fast and easy, and this will get you just a little bit of extra favor. On top of that, it also gives you two quest rewards, so if you haven't found a weapon yet, these two quest rewards should give you a guaranteed chance for a two-handed weapon, especially if you have your class rewards selected to be based, or your end rewards selected to be based on your class, which is turned on by default. After this, you're going to run up the hill and go to Kobold's new Ringleader, and you'll do this quest on Normal and Hard. Then you'll move on to Dirk's Got a Secret on Normal and Hard, and then finally, Information is Key on Normal and Hard. Once you've done this, you've earned 50 points of favor, and that's 100 DDO points. Do this on two more servers, and you've earned yourself 300 DDO points and the ability to buy every expansion on sale right now, that is the Mists of Ravenloft, the Menace of the Underdark, and the Shadowfell Conspiracy, for the low, low price of 300 points that you just earned in-game. Now, it's important to note that once you have your two-handed weapon, whatever that two-handed weapon is, you just get an upgrade from the Ember Great Axe. So say you get like a plus one Shocking Greatsword or a plus two Axiomatic Falchion. Once you get one of those, you no longer need to loot the chests anymore. You can pretty much ignore all of the chests from that point to make your running around even faster. Now, if you're confused and the visuals and the audio doesn't work for you, I actually did a run of this myself. I wanted to see how fast it was following my own guide. So in the description, I will link you to another video that I have uploaded, which is actually me doing the entire thing. So everything I just described, I did it as fast as I could. It took me about 43 minutes. If you're unfamiliar with some of the quests and you need to take time to pause and look around, it might take you about an hour, hour and 15. I was literally going as fast as I absolutely could, and it was about 45, but there's not a lot of optimization, just a lot of quick, simple menuing. If you're somebody who actually has VIP, so you don't need to run quests Normal, Hard, and then Elite, you can just open on Elite. Instead, you have a separate quest list, which is doing all of the quests on the Korthos Village, so the Storehouse Secret, Hayton's Rest, Caneth Crystal, and Collaborator, all on Elite, and then immediately booking it to the harbor and running Information is Key on Elite first and Kobold Ringleader on Elite. That is also 50 favor, however, it doesn't require you to do Normal or Hard. This is assuming you can already open up Elite if you want to earn this favor super quick on a brand new server. And finally, if you happen to find yourself on a server, whether you're brand new or you made a brand new account and you're unsure, and you see a group that is open doing quests on Elite that you can just join in, that will be faster than trying to run a lot of this stuff by yourself, because other people will be able to help you out, and it'll go pretty fast. You'd be surprised how fast some of these harbor groups can go by, especially since you only need 50 favor. Now, the last thing I wanted to bring up, since there may be some people who have never really played Dungeons & Dragons online, who are watching this video, and I want to give you an extra tip. For those of you that did not know, this is actually Dungeons & Dragons Online 15th birthday. That's right, it's the 15th anniversary of Dungeons & Dragons Online, so there is actually another code, which is HappyDDO15, and by putting HappyDDO15 into the bar, you actually get a special cloak, which is very, very cool. It's a cosmetic cloak, and you get a permanent copy of it for all of your characters. And on top of that, the first character that you log into is given a special cake. I think it's a cake or a ticket, one of the two. And you take this and you give it to a genie who is in House Fjarlin, and he gives you access to any piece of raid gear from the list. Well, raid gear, special items, that sort of thing. And there's a whole bunch of good options. If you're brand new and just starting out and you're unsure about what to take, I highly recommend if you can commit either to one character, I would go ahead here and grab an item called the Quiver of Alacrity. The Quiver of Alacrity is an item you can put on at level 1, and it gives you 30% extra movement speed all of the time. It's an extremely valuable item, and it just makes your moving around feel incredibly good. Additionally, there's actually a weird thing with the Quiver of Alacrity, in that it's a bound to character item, because it does come from a raid. However, if you can get some bound to account arrows, and you can get bound to account arrows from doing some Caneth crafting, you can take those bound to account arrows that you crafted yourself using Caneth crafting, put them in your Quiver of Alacrity, and as long as those are the only things in the quiver will actually count as bound to account. And you can actually share it with your other characters as long as you use your account-wide storage. If you are fully free to play, you don't have account-wide storage, but you can buy it in the store or just subscribe to get access to the storage system. I'm really psyched that SSG has taken this opportunity to give everybody all the quests for free, and I'm really excited because I'm about to launch a brand new series on this channel called Beginner Basics, where I'm going to go through all of the character classes and different situations you're going to find yourself in to be able to get you started on your adventures with the right knowledge to get going. So big thanks to SSG for giving out all of these quests and for bringing in so many more people into the game, and I'm super excited to see how this is going to affect how many people are going to be sticking around and playing in 2022. That's all I've got for you today. Thank you for watching. If you really like what you see, make sure you subscribe and please like this video if this has helped you out. Try to put a lot of effort into these videos, and I'm going to keep doing that in the future. Additionally, if you're still saying, hey man, this is cool stuff, but I would love to have seen that run live where you actually ran through and did all the quests, man, you probably gave out some helpful tips. I did, and you can see it on twitch.tv/streamtom. I stream basically every day, and you can get the chance to see what the heck is going on there, what I got going with the Dungeons & Dragons Online. New stuff, new tips and tricks. Check that out, twitch.tv/streamtom. Anyways, that's all I have for you today. Thank you for watching, and enjoy all the content. There's too much good content in DDO to not enjoy, so have a good time. Buh-bye.